Well, if you've been stuck at home for the past couple of months or a couple of years, I do hope that you've been working on that beach body of yours, because the country is slowly opening up and it is time to travel again. But of course, making sure that you take care of the proper safety and health protocols. For this special two-part episode, we're back in the beautiful and famous island of Bohol. And what better way to open up a fresh episode than with a fresh face? I want to introduce my new co-host. She is Bini Bining Pilipinas Intercontinental 2015, as well as being a DJ, a model, a host, and most importantly, a certified beach lover. Please welcome Christi McGarry.
Hey, y'all. Hey, Mark, good to see you here.
Oh, it's very nice to have you. And you know, I understand that you really want to get into freediving. So I guess Bohol is a perfect place for you to do your first episode.
Absolutely. The last time I was in Bohol, it was for the Panglao Dive Festival. I got a little taste of freediving. I love being in the oceans. I'm so excited for the activities that we have in store for us for these episodes.
Awesome. Well, what do you say? Should we get started?
Yeah, let's do it. I'm Christi.
And I'm Mark. And this is
Beached.
A haven of tropical beauty, Bohol ranks among the best destinations in Southeast Asia. You'd think that Bohol is just a small area in the central Visayas, but you'll really get to appreciate its beauty more when you get to see a bird's eye view of the province.
Interestingly, the province is composed of the main Bohol Island and 73 islands and islets surrounding it. Fortunately, we'll get to see them from high up in the sky with Air Taxi PH.
We're here with Paige, who is the EVP of Air Taxi PH. Thanks so much for joining us, Paige.
We're happy to have you here. Thank you so much for having me too.
Can you tell us a little bit about Air Taxi PH?
We've been operating for about 25 years now. We have a fleet of 26 aircraft, jets and helicopters flying around the region. We have Gulfstream jets that can fly all the way to Australia or Japan. It can fly to any island in the Philippines at an airport because it can land in short and unprepared runways. And we have helicopters to fly point to point in cities and provinces.
So I see that you have a variety of aircrafts to choose from, but can you tell us a little bit more about the aircraft that we'll be flying in?
You guys will be flying the Pilatus PC-12NG. NG stands for next generation. It's the perfect island aircraft. So it's great for island hopping, going short distances. Manila to Bohol is perfect. It can land in unprepared runways such as other destinations like Amanpulo. It has one very unique feature. It has this big cargo door that you can load all your stuff in it. And aside from that, it's pretty modern with a nice glass cockpit. And then all the aircraft have been disinfected before and after every flight to make sure that the passengers are always safe. This is one thing that we've been doing ever since before the pandemic. And of course, now we test our crew regularly to make sure the passengers are always secure.
Well, that definitely sounds like the safest way to travel during a pandemic. Super excited to get on the Pilatus.
Me too, and experience the glass cockpit.
Yes. It's so cool.
One of the most famous destinations in Bohol is Panglao Island. It's a tourist favorite and should always be on your list if you're after crystal blue waters, white sand, and sea adventures.
The shores of this island are lined with five-star hotels and luxury resorts. One of them is South Palms Resort that will be our home for the next few days.
Oh, there's nothing as refreshing as fresh buko.
Hi, welcome to South Palms.
Hi, thank you.
And welcome to Panglao. Can I show you around?
Sure,
thanks
we'd
so
love
much.
That.
Absolutely.
Okay, so how was your trip in coming to Bohol?
It was beautiful. We had a wonderful flight on airtaxi.ph. So it was an absolute breeze. And then it's so nice that you guys are so close to the airport. We're here in no time at all and get to enjoy the beauty of the beach straight away.
Perfect. That's one of the assets that we have now, that South Palms is access very near to the airport. This is our Panglao villa. It's our two-bedroom villa.
Oh, okay, wow. So perfect for families as well.
Perfect for family. You have an exclusive jacuzzi.
Wow, with the beachfront.
This villa is one of our guests' most favorite. It has an exclusive veranda. As I have mentioned, just a few steps away, the beach is all yours.
Perfect.
Wow. Private beachfront property.
Okay, Christi, you're hosting the rest of the show on your own. I'll be here if you need me.
I'll take the reins and the villa.
South Palms, by the way, has the longest beachfront in the island.
Wow.
Privately owned.
How long is it?
It's 1.5 kilometers. It's one of Bohol's favorite.
Yeah, no, this is an absolutely stunning beach.
And then people here enjoy different water sports activities. Mm-hmm. These are our cabanas, place where usually our guests really want to have their massage here. Not in room, but here.
Yeah,
I mean, it's the best ambiance. You get the crashing sound of the waves right behind you. So there's nothing more relaxing than that.
Behind us is, of course, we have a swimming pool here and our F&B outlets. We have a pool bar where you are going to enjoy your DJ chill out while waiting for the sunset. And of course, behind us is our Oceanica restaurant. It sits 150. We serve like the most popular seafood variety.
Everything here is amazing so far. It just looks so beautiful, and it's a perfect place to get away from the hustle and bustle of the city and just chill out and relax with friends, family, or even on your own, I guess.
I know, and that's the reason why you came back, right?
Yes.
And keep coming back for more.
What's wonderful about Bohol is that it caters to all types of people. May you be an adrenaline junkie, an adventure seeker, or a beach bum. I do love adventure, but for today, we'll take this opportunity to just relax and enjoy this charming resort.
Don't you just love waking up to the sound of waves crashing and the view of clear blue waters? Stepping out of your room to walk on fine white sand is always a pleasant way to start your day.
What's wonderful about Bohol is that it caters to all types of people. May you be an adrenaline junkie, an adventure seeker, or a beach bum. I do love adventure. But for today, we'll take this opportunity to just relax and enjoy this charming resort.
With lovely rooms, a picturesque ocean view, and Instagrammable lounging areas, you won't run out of photos to post on your social media. But what I think makes your stay in South Palms Resort truly memorable are the people. They're super friendly, accommodating, and they always greet you with a smile. And I think that's the true nature of Boholanos. The locals are known to be very warm and approachable.
Speaking of photos and friendly people, this afternoon we've invited a friend over for a little bit of a catch-up. So, Martin, you're not a local from Bohol, right?
No, I'm originally from Manila.
And what did you do there?
I used to work in a post-production industry. I was a video editor and colorist. It's mainly for advertising, you know, commercials. And then I moved to Bohol in 2015. I moved here because the company I was working for closed, and then I decided to work full-time as freediving instructor.
How many records have you won over the years?
At the moment, it's 15 national records.
15 wow. National records. Wow.
Top that, someone.
Yeah, exactly. And then what made you decide to move to Bohol?
I'm an instructor in Freedive Panglao, and Freedive Panglao was one of the first freediving schools in the Philippines, and it's the first in Panglao in Bohol. I moved here because they organize a lot of competitions, especially the big ones,
yeah,
which is called the Asian Freediving Cup. I'm one of the instructors there,
and then the owner left. So now I'm one of the managers for the shop. Since there's many competitions here, and I was interested in competitions and doing a lot of training, and the depth here is very accessible. So I decided to move here instead of staying in Cebu.
Okay. Yeah. Do you miss the city at all?
No.
Okay, so I know this might be a tricky question, but not only do you freedive competitively, but you've also turned it into a creative craft. And like Marc mentioned earlier, are one of the best underwater photographers out there. So which do you prefer, or what are the pros and cons of each?
I like competing and training. I like to challenge myself. So from time to time, I like to compete, but I want to have some break as well. Mm. Right now, I prefer joining competitions outside of the country, and which is not possible at the moment because a lot of places that are organizing competitions are still closed.
Right. Mm.
So I'm focusing more on creating content, doing some photos and videos, and I enjoy it. I like making new stuff, you know.
I mean, I must ask, since you're now a local here, not originally, where's your favorite spot in Bohol?
I like diving in Balikasag. Mm. Also here in Napaling, when it's not wavy.
Where the sardines are?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Because it's super easy to dive there. You just walk down the stairs. It's like 5 meters and you see the drop off.
Yeah.
And there's sardines. So those two spots are my favorite in Bohol. For camping, for outdoors, there's a lot of places here that we still need to explore. So
awesome. Well, we're looking forward to exploring some of them with you.
Yeah.
Thanks again for showing people what life can be like.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thanks, Martin.
You're welcome.
After spending the whole day at the resort yesterday, Marc and I are so ready to take on today's activities: free diving and underwater photography. After spending the whole day at the resort yesterday, Marc and I are so ready to take on today's activities: free diving and underwater photography.
So we're here now at Bohol Beach Club, and we're going to meet up with our good friend, Martin Zapanta, who is our national record holder for free diving and also probably one of the best underwater photographers and editors you could possibly find. So he's going to help us get a little bit better at our free diving.
Yes.
And hopefully take some nice images of us as well. Hey Martin, what do you have in store for us?
So we will be diving here at the house reef of Bohol Beach Club. Mm-hmm.
All right, what do you have planned?
We'll do a photo shoot. Mm-hmm. Just fun diving.
All right,
we'll just enjoy the water.
And we a little like crash course in free diving, right?
We can do that also.
Okay.
All right, okay, well, shall we get our gear set up and maybe you can give Christi some extra pointers?
Just when you swim, try not to paddle with your hands.
Okay.
Okay, so it will look more relaxed and it will look nicer in pictures.
Gotcha. So turn my mermaid on.
Yeah.
Yes. All right. Mermaid and mermaid time. Let's go.
All right.
Both look very similar. Why is that one better than this?
Because of the size of the screw.
Uh-huh.
So if you compare the size, this one has more space. So if you have a bigger face, this will fit you better.
Okay.
So
this would like squash your face in?
Yeah.
So for comfort.
For comfort, and also like if you're gonna use it for ocean.
My expectation for this dive is to get wet. I'm pretty confident about that.
Just excited to get back in the water.
Let's do this.
Thank you.
How was your freediving sesh?
Well, after another crash course, it just feels really good to be in the water. And like I mentioned, to be one with the sea. It's so clear down there, so many beautiful corals. How was yours?
It was awesome. It's always a little bit more challenging when you're doing a photo shoot, especially when Martin says, okay, no weight belt, no snorkel, like all my comfort zone things when I freedive. Exhaling everything to stay down on the bottom.
We already talked about that before, that's one of my biggest challenges. I feel much more comfortable holding my breath in, but when you have to release everything that you have in order to sink, that's definitely a challenge. But I was definitely pushing it today, and I hope the pictures came out excellent.
I think that modeling underwater is a completely different area of freediving. How to hold your breath, how to maintain a position, how to exhale, how to not use all of your usual acclimates.
Totally. The dynamics are totally different. You need to learn how to position your body in ways that you're uncomfortable with. And you have fins as well, so it's another additional challenge in order to make sure your fins look graceful, your arms, and your face. It's definitely difficult to look flattering while you're holding your breath. But regardless, I think the backdrop is what makes the photos the most magical, because there's no other element as beautiful as the sea.
All right, so we're up from our free dive. Martin, what have you got to show us?
Here are some cool pictures from today's dive.
Ooh. Oh, I like those.
Nice, with the waterline there. Cool.
Even before editing, these look great.
Ooh, yeah, so merman.
Yes.
Ripped abs.
Yay.
Can't wait to see the final edits as well.
I just want to thank Paolo again and Bohol Beach Club, and of course Martin so much for taking the awesome photos.
You're welcome.
We will be able to see the edited pictures once Martin's done it, and I think they're going to be awesome.
Can't wait. And we can't wait to be back. Thanks again.
Thanks again, guys.
Our day is not over just yet. To welcome my new co-host, we're celebrating with some drinks at South Palms Bar. And there's a bit of a catch, and she's in for a surprise. And we're on our way back to the resort after that refreshing underwater experience. But our day is not over just yet. To welcome my new co-host, we're celebrating with some drinks at South Palms Bar, and there's a bit of a catch, and she's in for a surprise. What a beautiful night, and I love the setup that they've given us here too.
Yeah, gorgeous. The sunset's out, cocktails, we have some dishes that we can munch on.
And it's just a perfect ending to an awesome day. So what did you think of the freediving with Martin?
I mean, I think it's my third time doing a free dive with Martin, and each time, as you know, every dive, no two dives are the same. This one was particularly special.
It's funny because you told me beforehand that, I've tried it, but I'm not really good or anything. The impression that you gave me, it's like, okay, yeah, she'll stay under for a few seconds, but you're actually a lot better than that.
Thanks. I mean, I feel like I feel extremely comfortable in the water. I find like extreme peace there. How about you?
Yeah, no, I've always been a water boy ever since I was a kid. My parents were scuba diving instructors, so I was actually free diving down to them when they were doing their safety stuff when I was a kid, and they eventually taught me how to dive. But yeah,
for me, I didn't know that your parents were scuba instructors.
Yeah,
so it's in your blood naturally.
The water is definitely in my blood, but free diving, it's free. You feel so free without all of the bits and pieces. And nowadays, you've got the added bonus of having incredible photographers like Martin to take images that you just want to take home and frame.
A toast to an amazing day, to beached,
to Bohol. To my wonderful new co-host. So happy to have you on board, and you're perfect for the show.
Oh, thanks, Mark. Likewise. It's such a pleasure to be a part of the show with you as well.
Thank you very much.
To us.
Cheers to that. To us. Oh, that's good.
Delish.
That's really good. I like the music too. It's such an awesome sort of vibe going here.
Yeah, I mean, South Palms has really done a great job of creating an ambiance. I mean, look at the setup that we have. The beach is vibing, there's volleyball going on at the end, the sunset's perfect. I couldn't ask for a better night.
Yeah, you know, this DJ is actually pretty good. They've got DJ decks set up there, which is not something that resorts normally have. You DJ, right?
Yeah, I dabble.
You dabble. Don't lie, I've heard you DJ. You are very, very good. You know what? I think the people here in Bohol here tonight would really appreciate a little bit of Christi spinning the decks.
I mean, I did bring my USBs and my headphones, because don't
a good
leave
DJ,
home without
yeah,
it.
Yeah, exactly. So what do you say? You game?
You know what? For beach, I'm game.
All right. Woohoo! Oh, we're in luck.
And cheers to that. Again.
Cheers to that. Absolutely. Good to be back in Bohol again, and there were so many fun things that we did. What for you was your favorite?
I think one of my highlights might definitely have to be playing volleyball against the locals at South Palms. It got pretty competitive.
Yes, that was a whole lot of fun, and I've got to say, I really enjoyed winning with the help of the very talented locals against someone that actually used to really play.
Yeah. I might be a little bit rusty, but I promise I'll be back for a rematch. And aside from that, I also enjoyed being behind the decks again. I actually haven't DJed for a live audience in quite a while.
Well, you could not tell at all. You were phenomenal. Of course, some of the other great activities we did was the SUPing and then riding around on those wonderful, sustainable fan bikes. But I think the true highlight of this particular episode, I think for both of us, was probably our underwater photo shoot with Martin Zapanta.
100%, I couldn't agree more. The photos came out amazing, and just being in the ocean again is so revitalizing. It was such a blessing to be here in Bohol.
That's true. Straight out of the camera, the photos looked amazing, but once he puts his magical touch, it just turns it into, oh, pure artistry. Well, Christi, congratulations on making it to the end of your very first episode of Beached. And when we get to the end of an episode, we do something special called the Beached Rating. And it's pretty simple. Basically, we rate a destination in five different categories, which is sea, sand, stuff to do, scenery, and of course, sustainability. And we just give them a rating from 1 to 5 suns. Sound simple?
Sounds simple enough. I'm excited for my first beach rating. So for Bohol and for the category sea, I think it's pretty high up there, not only because the water is beautiful from the shorelines, but there are also amazing and awesome dive destinations, both for free diving and for scuba. So in that case, we are going to give Bohol the rating of 4.5 suns. 1, 2, 3, 4.5 suns.
All right, so next up, we have sand. Now, the sand here in Bohol is amazing. The stretch of coastline that we saw, and we know it's like 1.5 kilometers, was just beautiful white sand, and they took very, very good care of it. So we're very happy to see that. And for that reason, we are going to give Bohol 4.2 suns. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 0.2.
Now for stuff to do. We obviously had a pretty fun agenda, including the stand-up paddleboarding, the sustainable band bikes, volleyball by the beach, even a DJ performance, and a wonderful dinner, the photo shoot with Martin. So for this instance, we are going to give Bohol 3.5 suns. So 1, 2, 3, 0.5.
All right, we've only got two more categories to go, and the next one is scenery. Bohol is beautiful. There is so much to see here. Of course, the ocean's amazing, the beaches are amazing, but we also know that it is so green. And for that reason, we are going to give Bohol 3.5 suns. 1, 2, 3, and 0.5.
Now for our last category, which is really important to both Mark and I. During our visit here at South Palms, they did make sustainability a priority. They also have a project called South Farms, where they make sure that all their produce are locally grown, and they also help the community by giving them jobs during the pandemic. So for this reason, we are going to give them 4.2 suns. 1, 2, 3, 4.2 suns.
All right, and so that gives us a grand total of 19.9, so divided by 5 equals 3.98. We're gonna round that up to 4. And very, very deservedly so. Congratulations, Bohol, that's an awesome score.
Absolutely, and I think that score is well-deserved. As you can see, there's just so much to see in Doom Bohol. All the categories are very well-rounded out, so it's definitely a top destination to visit here in the Philippines.
I feel like there's so much more that we could do here in Bohol.
That's right. I feel Bohol has so much more to offer. I don't think we can squeeze it in just one episode, so you guys might just have to stay tuned. I'm Christi McGarry.
And I'm Marc Nelson. We'll see you next time here on Beached.